whatever he is, 1.5, 42 years old, and you don't decline in some way. I mean, Tom Brady used to be able to throw a ball about as far as anybody in the league. So has he declined? Of course he has. I mean, he's not, you know, he's not that age. But if you're declining and winning Super Bowls, that's pretty good, right?
All right, Chris.
I love Chris.
Wait, hold on. How do we tee up Rob for this?
No,
this
what?
We're just going to let him go because we know his relationship with Tom Brady.
I have no relationship with Tom Brady.
Is he sliding into your Twitter DMs at this point?
No.
Rob, is Tom Brady really declining?
Absolutely. Chris Collinsworth is 100% right. And look, when you win a Super Bowl, it covers up all the warts. Tom Brady had more warts than a witch last year, if you were honest and took a deep look at his skin, okay? Seriously, can I just give you some numbers? Second half of the year, first half of the year, 16 touchdowns, 7 interceptions, 99 passer rating. Second half, 9 touchdowns, 4 interceptions, and a 91% passer rating. Tom Brady, and you want to look at the last 3 years as well, all the numbers are going down, and I get it. He's older, and the only reason that the narrative is different is because Tom Brady hitched his wagon on a defense that beat the Rams. Tom Brady didn't throw a touchdown. He had an interception. He had a fumble. He had an awful Super Bowl game.
His worst Super Bowl of his 9 Super Bowls.
Okay,
right?
But it was bad.
It was, yeah.
He's won 2 Super Bowls now, Jason, where he's thrown a total of 1 touchdown. His very first one and the last one.
He's won 2 Super Bowls with 1 touchdown.
I'm just saying, so if they would have lost and they only scored 3 points or whatever it was, 13 points in Tom Brady, the narrative would be totally different. We saw Tom Brady earlier last year where he was trying to throw the ball out of bounds in Pittsburgh. He couldn't even have enough mustard on it to get it out of bounds.
Dude, that was
it was intercepted. It was true. So let's just be honest. Tom Brady can talk about wanting to play till he's 45. I get it. When you win, people are more apt to give you the benefit of the doubt. If this was anybody else and Tom Brady didn't win or Tom Brady wasn't lucky enough to get the Falcons to choke and for Seattle to throw a bad interception at the goal line, you would be looking at it totally different. Tom Brady has declined. Let's just face the facts. It doesn't mean he's off or he can't play and he's not a good quarterback, but he's not as great as people make him out to be.
Rob, I agree with you.
What?
I do agree with you.
What? Yeah, he's joking, right?
Tom Brady is definitely declining, but he's not falling off a cliff by any stretch.
Didn't you see the video of him and his daughter? I'm telling you. He fell off the cliff.
He's jumping off a cliff.
Jumped off the cliff. But when I look at Tom Brady, I look at someone who understands what he's up against. Now, he understands he's getting older, so now I have to beat you in different ways. I'm not going to make, as Chris Collinsworth alluded to, I'm not going to be able to make those throws that I once did and throw the ball 50, 60, 70 yards down the field 10-plus times a game. That's not my style. What I'm going to beat you with is my savviness and my mental sharpness. So I'm going to see and dissect the defense, know where I need to go, have my guys in the position that they need to be in, and put the ball on the money. Now, what the New England Patriots have done that I completely applaud them for is they've strategically placed him in a situation now where he doesn't have to bear the load. So you acquire a running back and you say, here, you know what? We're going to allow you to run the ball and rush the ball a lot more. When you look at their rushing attempts, their rushing attempts in 2017, 448 rushing attempts. Their rushing attempts last year, 478. They were 5th in the NFL in rushing in 2018. They weren't even in the top 10 in 2017. So when you look at those dynamics, you're going to get a different type of Tom Brady, a Tom Brady that's not going to be called upon to win the game from the first quarter to the fourth. No, we need you to be as sharp as you can be at the waning moments of the game. This is how it's played when you get up in age. When we look at in the National Basketball Association, the older guys, when do we want you the most fresh? We want you the freshest in the playoffs. You look at a guy like Iguodala for the Golden State Warriors. Didn't play a lot in the regular season, but when it came to the playoffs, who was on the court all the time? Andre Iguodala, because we know he provides a value that we can't expend in the regular season. So what am I saying about Tom Brady? We know what you provide us. We don't need you to be the Tom Brady of 2010, 11, 12, all these Super Bowl MVPs and league MVPs. We don't even need that. We need you to be that guy when it's the clutch time of the game, 2 minutes left. Can you pull it out for us? Yes, I can, Coach. I'm your guy.
Boy, Greg, one of the best little speeches you've made this week. I got to applaud you, Greg, and I agree largely with that. I disagree that decline is the right word here, gentlemen.
Why? The numbers say it.
I'm going to tell you. I do believe, as Greg said, they are pivoting from a Tom Brady-led passing attack with Gronk, with the dual tight ends, with Randy Moss, and they're reinventing themselves as a run team, meaning fewer passes for Brady, easier passes. That's why I believe his QBR is down. His quarterback passer rating is down. Some of the lowest in five years, but it's not because he's declining. It's because they're reinventing
themselves. No, it's because they know that he can't make those passes.
He can still make them. Rob,
no,
they don't have, they have different players. They have different, they're reinventing themselves. You know Madonna, the singer, reinvented herself from the 80s to the 90s. She's pivoted. In business, this happens all the time. I mentioned Drake earlier this week. He was like a teen idol on one of these Nickelodeon shows. He's now a rapper. People change and reinvent themselves. That's what Brady's doing. He's no longer throwing deep bombs to Randy Moss. He doesn't have Gronk in the seam. He's going to become a run team. He will definitely continue to play and succeed with the Patriots.
The reason why guys like Tom Brady continue to play at a high level and be as consistent and just have the longevity, it's because of what Jason is talking about, and I'm surprised that I'm agreeing with Jason right now. But
see, now your compliment to me, I don't want. I'm done.
He's rejecting that.
Their ability to not conform, but to reinvent themselves to a certain degree. When you look at guys like Larry Fitzgerald, who went from one of the elite wide receivers in all of the National Football League, to now he's pretty much a hybrid tight end. He's learned to reinvent himself, which is why he's still consistently productive and an impact player. Not because he's outside the numbers and he's doing the same things that we saw him doing early in his career. No, he's understanding that times change. My body changes. Tom Brady, for you to sit here and say that he can't make those throws, that is completely false.
I saw that
he can make all the throws.
No, he can't. Go watch that game in Pittsburgh. Go watch it.
He can make all the throws.
When have you seen Tom Brady throw
the Super Bowl, the pass to Gronk, the most important play in the Super Bowl, and he nailed it.
He missed so many throws in that Super Bowl.
Somebody hit the most important one.
He misses throws now. That play in Pittsburgh, to me, I wish we had the video.
We do have the video. They've been showing it on a loop here because they love clowning Tom Brady.
No, it's not, but I'm saying
there it is right here, Rob.
That was one of those where he's trying to get the ball out of bounds.
He's off his back foot.
He can't even throw it out of bounds.
Off his back foot.
He can't throw it out of bounds. Tom Brady in the past would be able to do that. I get it. As you get old, you want to make adjustments. I'm telling you, Bill Belichick knows what he's working with. He's working with a 42-year-old who can't do it. Thank goodness for Sony Michel. If it wasn't for him, they wouldn't win a Super Bowl. They wouldn't.
You know who's reinventing themselves? It's Rob Parker. We should push on the picture of you losing 30 pounds, working out, reinventing yourself at 52 years old.
You know why I can't give you a lot of credit on that particular play? Because he's using his brain as well. He's being strategically smart as well.
So he wanted to throw a pick?
No, he didn't want to throw the pick, but he understands I have to get it in the vicinity of one of my players or I'm going to lose a down.
Intentional grounding.
Is it going to be intentional grounding? He could have easily threw it straight to the sideline, but that's not what smart quarterbacks do. When you think about plays like that, you're throwing off your back foot, you have a guy draping over you, you're trying to get the ball out of bounds, but young quarterbacks make the mistake of just throwing it straight to the sideline and then losing a down. Tom Brady is at the mentality of, you know what, I know the situation, I know what needs to be done.
So you'd rather give up the football than a down. Is that what you're telling me?
I mean, they're inside the 10-yard line. That's pretty much a
But you want to give up the football? Tom Brady wanted to give up the football.
No, nobody wants to give up the football, but I would rather take that then have an intentional. Well, I wouldn't rather take that. Okay. I mean, I can't.
The narrative on Tom Brady would be totally different if they lost the Super Bowl. And I get it. You guys love it's all about the Super Bowl, no matter whether he contributes or not. Everybody talks about the 500 yards he threw. Is it about yards or is it about points? Tom Brady left points on the field in against Philadelphia in the Super Bowl. He also coughed up the football in the final 2.5 minutes that cost him the game.
I mean, the defense gave up 35 points to Nick Foles. Stop. Rob,
but that doesn't mean that Tom Brady didn't leave points on the field.
AFC title game. I can't believe.
What did you want him to do?
I can't believe the producers don't have video from the AFC title game. Chiefs, Patriots, okay?
Overtime.
The close game. What happens in overtime, Rob? Tom Brady, when the Chiefs know exactly what's coming.
Tom Brady threw a game-losing interception, and Ford was off.
In the fourth quarter. Yes, that happened.
Did that not happen?
What happened in overtime? Tell me.
No, but did that not happen?
Tom Brady made every damn pass.
It's the same thing I'm talking about.
Right on the spot, down the field, buzzsaw.
If Ford is not offsides, and that's the way that game ends, people aren't talking about Tom Brady at 42 years old the same way.
Rob,
he was that close to coughing up the game. Let's just be honest.
His world has too many ifs.
Close.
If. Let's just deal in reality and facts. What happened in the AFC title game in overtime? Just break down every play. Tom down the field. We're going to the slot. We're going in the seam. The Chiefs knew what was coming, and they couldn't stop Brady. Every point, pinpoint accuracy, every pass. It was magnificent. You're just
Do you know what the coach on the other sideline was? Andy Reid? Yeah. You know how many big games he's won?
So we're turning the tables.
I mean,
it's not about Brady. It's about Andy Reid.
Are you shocked that Andy Reid couldn't win a big game? What a shocker. That's his middle name.
You know, I'm a New Yorker who loves the Jets, and I'm praising Tom Brady because that's the right thing to do here. He is greatness personified. The guy is amazing.
And the New England Patriots understand we don't have a guy to replace this man right now.
Because they blew it.
So we have to make sure we protect all of what he is and how great we know he can be for us, but we need to do that in a matter of making sure he can be that guy in the moments we need him to be that guy. You look at just his sacks. His sacks in 2017, he got sacked 35 times versus 21 times this past year. You got to make sure, you got to know we can't allow him to get not only sacked, but quarterback hits. They have to go down. You have to protect the guy.
That's all the dinking and dunking they do now because they know that.
It's effective.
My favorite moment from this segment was where Rob said, Tom Brady has won 2 Super Bowls where he only threw a touchdown pass. Do we have a list of how many guys kill to win 2 Super Bowls, Rob?
But I'm just saying, he gets all the credit as if it's always about Tom Brady.
He doesn't always. I mean,
yes, he does.
Belichick gets a lion's share of the credit.
No, it's always about Tom Brady.
Because he's been doing it for so long.
They couldn't even fake and give him the MVP this past year. Even though you said he made all the throws that needed to be made in the fourth quarter, I'm talking about
in the Super Bowl, the pass to Gronk, right?
But they even couldn't fudge it and give Tom Brady the MVP. That's how poorly he played.
No, he wasn't great in the game. But Jared Goff, by the way, young star on the other side.
I've been painting.
He got to make one pass to Brandon Cooks and couldn't.
I've been painting this scenario for years now. I'm going to be right this year.
Eventually, you will be right.
How about this? We should make a deal. He has to retire this Brady take if the Patriots win the Super Bowl.
No, that ain't happening.
Even if they win it, you know, whatever. All right, folks. Did the Clippers and Ty Lue just pull the ultimate troll job on Rob Parker's second best friend, LeBron?
What?
That's next.